We now invite Director Hu to give us an introduction about the daily life of children. Director Hu is the director of the affiliate kindergarten to South China Normal University. Yeah. And the daily activity, I would like to give you a brief introduction. In China, the preschool and kindergarten programs have two different kinds. One is daycare, which is pretty similar to full day usually. They're in China, there are a few half day programs. Most of them are full day. That's from 7:30 to 5:30. And some of the schools or programs are, we call it boarding school, like the one of the Director Guan. But the majority are daycare. Okay. And Director Hu will introduce the a child's life in the typical daily care center.
Okay. 尊敬的比尔教授，各位老师，还有我们的同行，下午好。
Good afternoon, everyone, and Professor Bill Mendes and other friends here.
下面我就从微观的一个角度和以个案的形式给大家介绍一下我们华斯幼儿园的孩子在幼儿园一天的生活情况。Now
I'd like to take this opportunity to introduce the daily life of a case as a child, and to give you some impression about the life of children in the kindergarten in China.
我们这个孩子的名字叫做邱月成。
The name of the child I'm going to introduce is Chu Yue Chen.
是我们大六班的孩子。
And he's in the K3 class. That's he's 5 and 6 years old. That's in kindergarten. Okay.
下面我就从早晨入园一直到下午离园的这样一个流程。 给大家做一个简单的介绍。
I'll introduce the whole process from he's going to the kindergarten to the time he left the kindergarten. Okay.
这是早晨，邱月成的妈妈带着邱月成上幼儿园。
This is from 7:46. Well, the mother coming to the kindergarten. So usually, they will walk, and in China, people will drive, but some will drive, but most of them will walk because it's on campus.
邱月成随着妈妈来到了幼儿园的门口。So
they walked in through the gate of the kindergarten.
走进幼儿园。And
then there's a regular morning physical check. Well, every time when a child comes into the kindergarten, they need to get to take the temperature, and then before they can go into the classroom.
今天是邱月成做班上的值日生。This
boy is on duty on that day, so he will be very busy that day because he has many responsibilities.
8点钟的时候，小朋友都基本上已经入园。邱月成在完成他值日生的第一项工作，就是点名。Well,
usually at 8, every child is expected to arrive. So at 8, this boy who is on duty will need to check the name of each child to make sure that whether they have come or not.
8点钟后，小朋友要进早餐。邱月成作为值日生。 在为其他的小朋友服务。And
it's time for breakfast, so he will need to help serve the other child because he was on duty that day.
给大家服务完了以后，邱月成和大家一起再进早餐。Then
after serving each of his classmates, then he will sit down and have breakfast.
吃完早餐，哎，怎么是空的？ 吃完早餐以后，邱月成和其他小朋友一起来到老师身边，在那里做餐后阅读。After
the breakfast, they will have story time, and they will have to form a small group, and the teacher will begin to tell story.
下面是我们的第一个室内的教学活动时间。
And after that, they will have an indoor teaching hours. That's the learning hours.
这个活动呢是让小朋友一起来感受勺子的不同的材质和形状。
Well, the purpose of this learning activity is to enable the child to sense the spoons of different material, to sense the weight, the smell, and the color, and to let the child know the different material.
九点钟以后，课后他们进行上厕所、洗手。
At about 9 o'clock, there's a break time, so that they can go to the washroom, they wash hands and have some water.
准备后面到室外做早操。
And prepare for the morning physical exercise outdoor.
早操活动完了以后，就是户外活动。
And then, yeah, that's the outdoor activities.
他们这次的户外活动是叫做踩高跷。
Well, this time, that day is a steel walk, so they have walking on it while it's practicing the balance.
大概三十分钟左右以后，他们就要收拾。
About 30 minutes later, they have to, you know, to clean the outdoor the floor by themselves.
户外活动完以后，回到课室。
Then they will go back to the classroom.
他们在一起学会自己擦汗，自己穿衣服。
And they need to change clothes for themselves. That's the self-help skill.
接着是我们的课间餐。
Then it's snack time at 10 o'clock.
水果餐。
They have some fruit and grapes that day.
一切就绪以后，我们就要进行第二次的活动，也就是走出幼儿园，进到社区。
After that, they will have a second activity. That's to go into the community. Because that day, their theme is to learn about something about spoon. Okay, so they're in indoor classroom. In the classroom, they feel the different kind of spoon. And now they go into the community.
在社区，我们的孩子们非常有礼貌，看到了劳动那个清洁工人，他们跟他们打招呼。
And they're very polite when they saw the old people, they will say hello. It's kind of social interaction. Okay.
他们来到了超市，每个孩子就去找不同的勺子和不同的材质做的一些勺子。
So they go into the supermarket, a store on campus, and to find different kinds of spoons and with different colors and material.
大家找完以后，同伴之间互相比较，看谁找的最多，谁找的最好。
And the peers will compare how much I found, how many different kinds of spoon I have found, and how about you? And they will compare. That's kind of peer support and peer learning.
回到课室以后，他们要准备吃中餐。
Then they're ready for lunch. mushroom and. And the seaweed soup with eggs.
邱月成小朋友是值日生，他要继续来完成他的服务工作。
He was on duty that day again, and he need to serve the people.
又不行
了。有点慢。Okay.
他有个洗手。
Okay.
对，就在这儿。他现在正在吃饭。
yeah.
怎么会是回过去了？他在完成他值日生的工作，在摆那个饭菜和筷子。
So you were setting the table for his classmates.
今天吃的是紫菜鸡蛋汤。
And then have seaweed soups with eggs.
吃完饭以后，就开始进行清洁工作。
Then he will need to clean the tables with his classmates. So everything is done by themselves. It's not by the teacher. The purpose is to practice their self-help skills.
清洁工作完以后，他铺好了自己的床。
They have the mattress and ready for a nap.
12:20, 他已经睡着了。
And then he had a nap at 12:20.
睡两个多小时以后就起床。
About 2 hours later, they will begin to, to do the bath.
起床以后，小朋友要漱口和刷牙。
And then have teeth brushing.
3:00开始进午餐。
And then, and then they have afternoon snacks again. Have another snack.
吃完午餐就是户外在走廊上的一个听故事和讲故事的时间。
After that, it's a story time, and the teacher will tell stories.
3:30是我们的第二次集体的教学活动。
And at 3:30, there's another group learning activity. That's about the decomposition of four. That's a math class.
他在我们邱月成小朋友和小朋友一起在讨论。怎么样在一棵树枝上，两棵树枝，一棵树枝上画出四个苹果。
They are discussing how to draw four apples on one tree, because they are learning about four. So there is a true trunk and how to draw the apples, four apples on, okay.
其实这就是我们的一个数学活动，分解与组成。
That's about the decomposition and composition of numbers. So if they have two branches, they can.Draw three apples here and one there, and we will make four. And if they draw two here, two there, and they also make four, something like that.
想好以后，他们就在上面画苹果。
Then after discussing with the peers, they begin to draw the apples.
下午4:00要进行户外活动。
And then at about four o'clock, they will need to be ready for outdoor activity again.
他们来到了操场，在进行热身运动。
Well, there's a warm-up exercise.
今天玩的游戏是，平衡接力比赛。
Well, the game that afternoon is the working on balance beams.
一个小时以后，又回到了课室。
And after hours of outdoor activity, they go back to the classroom.
换好衣服，喝完水以后，就进行了自由活动时间。
After changing clothes, they have free time, so they can choose from.Among all those material and play by themselves.
他选择了玩积木。5:00以后就开始放学。
His choice is to play with blocks. And after 5, it's time the school is over.
又到前面去了。
Okay.
5:00以后放学，他作为值日生就要开始拖地呀。整理一些桌椅板凳。
And because he was on duty, so he would need to clean the floor. So it's very busy that day. Well, actually, the kids take turns to be on duty, so they all have their chance to serve the others and be served. Okay.
邱月成戏称这是武术式的拖地。
It's like it's the kung fu, you say.
他对他值日生的工作非常的敬业。
He's very, very responsible for his work, and so he's have cleaned the floor.
一切就绪以后，他等着妈妈来接他。
When everything is done, they're waiting for his mother to come for pickup. But before they come in, you can practice writing his name on the wall. Here, this is the area that the children can write their name on it.
妈妈现在来接他，他在跟小朋友和老师再见。
And the mother will usually come at around 7:30 to pick up their child.
这个一日生活的流程大概就是这样。
That's a typical daily life of the children.
我们这样一个流程，就是说，不是说每个小孩都是这样的流程。每天的值日生活动，我们每个孩子分的内容是不一样的。邱月成他这一次分的是生活方面的一种值日，那么还有一些是学习方面的，还有一些是互助的。
Well, not everyone has the same schedule, and but every child in the kindergarten will be on duty, have a chance to be on duty, and when some child will help the others, say be responsible.For learning activity, for example, distribute the material or something. And in this case, this boy is just, well, serve the other people. Foods and, you know, cleaning and those things, yeah. But the duty may be different for each different child.
这样做的目的就是让我们的孩子要了解生活，融入生活，最后达到能够适应生活。
The basic purpose of this kind of arrangement is to let the child to learn from life, okay, and then to integrate their learning into life, and also eventually they can adapt to their life.
好，谢谢大家。
Thank you very much. And say goodbye to teacher and say goodbye to Director Hu after he finished to his presentation. And, well, of course, there's a graduate celebration for the children after, well, they graduate. There is a very, very big ceremony. And besides that, well, we have, just now, Director Guan mentioned about three teachers. One is parent, teacher, and environment. We talk about teacher, we talk about environment. Now we would like to talk about parent. So we would like to invite Director Yuan, Director Liang from Shunde to give us some information about how they motivate the parent to get involved. That will be the last section of today's presentation.